Hello and welcome to episode 4 of Let's Play Rose Online. My name is Max the Dragon. In this episode, we will continue doing some quests in Zant, and we might visit the next area. Let's log in. So here's our dealer character. Alright, we're back in Zant. You always spawn here if you log in. So let's continue doing the quests. Last time we were supposed to talk to Cornell, the village chief, and the quest was in here, but last time I recorded a Let's Play episode, this one, there was a server maintenance, so I had to cancel the recording. But we can just visit him again and we will get the quest that we were supposed to get by talking to him. So, this is Cornell. I am the chief of Zant. I know everything about this town. So is there anything you'd like to ask? Are you still having Woopie related woes? So yeah, he says something different when you meet him for the first time, but you can still take the quests from him if you abort them, which is what I did. You better believe it, the darn things won't stop howling. And on top of that, the chefs and gluttons have all my cooking supplies. I can help hunt Woopies for you. So yeah, that's how we get the quest. And there's one more quest. He wants us to gather supplies from the Woopies. Yeah, and if you meet him for the first time and you take those quests, you get some more extensive dialogue. But unfortunately, I can't display that here. Yeah, so it's been a couple of days since we did the last episode. There were some real life things that came up, and a couple of times where I wanted to record an episode, we were met with server maintenance, scheduled maintenance, and the server goes offline during that time, so it's a bit difficult to record an episode when that happens. There's another quest you can take here from Leonard, the Righteous Crusader. In order to become stronger than others, you'll have to train harder than the next. However, if you need help, I'm here for you. So how can I help you? Initially, it's not clear which option gives you the quest. If you pick, I heard that you have something for me to do. Then he says, ah, that's just another rumor. Oh man, I think I got tricked again. But the actual option you have to choose is, I'm a little bored. Then he says, then let me tell you a story. I had made a trip last week into Elverloon Desert. I was there in a party, and we had cleared the area with ease. It went well, if I don't mind bragging. But during the commotion, I had lost my old sword. Now, it's not amazing, but it has served me through many hard battles, and has proven to be very reliable. Hmm, I know this wasn't really a story, but do you think you can help me try and find my old sword? I feel a little ripped off here, but I suppose I can help you look for it. Thank you, Rose Let's Play. If it helps, our party was fighting off the Rakis in the southern region of the Elverloon Desert. That does help. I'll be back once I've found your sword. And if you don't find it? Well then, I probably won't return. So yeah, this is a quest that involves finding a sword. We can't do it yet because it requires you to go into Elverloon Desert. You used to be able to go there directly from this map, but they removed the crossover was here into the northern region, which is the Elverloon Desert. But they removed the bridge, or it's broken, so you can't go there unless you go through the next area, which is Breezy Hills. And since there are a lot of quests in that area as well, we're just gonna leave this for now. But yeah, you can do 10 quests simultaneously, so you can just leave this in your quest list. These quests are our current obligation. We're level 21, so we might be able to kill the Woopies. But before we do that, let me just pick up this quest here by Sparrow. Eccentric Adventurer Sparrow. My inventions are ahead of their time. Come, take a look at the fruits of my genius. Okay, so this guy sells guns and carts. He sells only guns for now. Carts is something you can do at level 50. So yeah, just take the quest by selecting this. You seem unwell. Are you alright? Do you think so too? So what happened? Well, I was busy working on my vaccine formula when these Woopies and Woopie chefs invaded and made a mess of my lab. Among all the stuff they ransacked, they stole my vaccine formula. You're working on a vaccine? Well, I'm a gun and cart inventor, so I don't specialize in medicine. But I can't stand those monsters infected with the Devil Pest, and decided that I should create a vaccine. Wahahaha! Devil Pest? What is the Devil Pest? You really don't know the Devil Pest, do you? Everyone knows it's a virus which makes tame monsters become dangerous. So you're saying that the Devil Pest is making monsters violent? Well, there isn't much scientific proof, but it's true. I hate to admit it, but those Arumic inventors actually know much more about this than me. But I can't stand it when they make me look stupid. Is there anything I can do to help? Huh? You? Right, you! Bring me my stolen vaccine formula from those Woopies and Woopie chefs. Do this for me, and I'll tell you a little more about the Devil Pest. Alright, I'll help you. Ha ha ha. Thanks. First, find and defeat at least 5 Woopies and Woopie chefs to retrieve the formula. Remember, there's a total of 2 pages you have to find. 2 pages, got it. This actually closes the conversation. We can choose this option to get a hint on where these monsters can be found. Where can I find those monsters? I'm sure they're not very far from here. They must be wandering around Zant. Alright. So, the howling sound that you hear in the background, that's actually the Woopies, so they're very close. And since we also have to kill them for these other quests, Wascally Woopies and Chef Surprise. You get that more often where in a certain area you take multiple quests that sort of involve you killing the same type of monsters. And if you kill a certain monster that is an objective for 2 quests or even more, then killing one monster will actually count towards both of the quests or all of them. So it's faster to do them simultaneously. I think that's all of the quests. You can see that there's a lot of player vendor shops here. So yeah, remember to sell items if you have them in your inventory. It's a good way to make money early on. I think we still have enough inventory space. So yeah, I'm gonna try to see if I can fight these. They're brown colored, so we should be able to fight them. But these Woopies will be again a bit stronger than what you've been facing so far, even the hornets and the bees. So yeah, let's just try. Let's attack one. Okay. So yeah, the advantage of a dealer and using guns or cannons is that the enemy, if it's not a ranged enemy, it'll have to take some time to come to you, and during that move you can actually get a few shots off, which helps getting a kill quickly without getting damaged too much. Because as you can see, once he gets to attacking range, he's already pretty much dead. When you're playing a soldier, you can't do that unless you're playing a crossbow soldier. And in that case, you just have to make sure that your armor has high enough stats to deal with more damage being dealt to you. Yeah, so that's going well, actually. So we also have to kill some chefs. Let's see. There, let's try that one. So that one looks like a ranged attacker. Yeah. Eat grape. Okay, yeah, so as you can see, you get a chef hat for one of the quests, and then also a proof of monster extermination for this one. So it's good to do these quests at the same time. Okay, we got an elixir, and that's good. Now you might notice that it says F1 to F12 on both of these bars, but you actually trigger this one using Alt plus the function key. So if you want to eat food, you can press Alt F1, but I'm just used to clicking on it. So there's another candle ghost, so we should be careful attacking a monster, because we might just run into the candle ghost while we're fighting. So, generally, if you're fighting at night, you just want to stay clear of these ghosts, and unless you can handle them. And yeah, just be mindful of your surroundings, because other players fighting monsters can also cause candle ghosts to appear when they kill them, and those candle ghosts can still attack you. So we're close to level 22. Now, to make this this fighting a little more interesting, once we get to half of the requirement, which is 15, 30 in total, so the half of it is 15, we're gonna go back into the city, and I'll show you how to refine some armor. That's something you can do if you think you're getting damaged too much. We seem to be handling ourselves quite well with our food, but I'll show you anyway. It does require some money, but we have enough from selling these elixirs and other chemicals. Okay, so yeah, we want to stay clear of that. Actually, let's head in there right now. Or you can, if you're being chased by a candle ghost, you can just run back into town. It'll still follow you around, but other players might help killing it for you. Wow, this is a... Let's see if we can damage it. Oh, this guy is pretty strong. Yeah, if you're not strong enough to kill these candle ghosts, they can be quite a nuisance. But running and just getting a few shots off might help. If you can outrun them, that's a tactic you can use. There we go. So that gives us level 22. And we'll just refine our armor. And then we'll return to killing Woopies. So, refining is something we did already with our gun. Let's just first repair our equipment, if it's necessary. Well, I think we did that in the last episode already. So I'd like to upgrade my item. You have to first unequip your gear to be able to refine it. And then it tells you what you need. So you always need the bind rune, or the talisman for weapons, or the apotrope for back items and face items. And shields. And you can optionally add catalysts, but we won't do that. So you can buy bind runes here at the armor guy. Just select the tab Refines and Tools, and we will just buy, let's see, they cost 500 each, so let's say 20 for now, and we can do a lot of refining for that. Something I forgot to mention last time, the refining itself costs a lot of Zuli as well. So that's something you should be aware of. The first time you upgrade it from 0 to 1, it doesn't cost anything. But then, wow, I failed that one. It's a 95%. That can happen. Let's try again. Okay, good. So yeah, as you can see, it starts going up pretty quickly. So make sure you always have enough money to purchase these upgrades. But if you manage to upgrade it successfully, then the stats will go up, and that might be very helpful in battle if you're getting damaged too much, or you want to deal more damage if you refine your weapon. So yeah, let's upgrade it to, say, 4 for each of the items. Okay, that went smoothly. Oh, so sometimes you can fail one, but that's not a big deal. So you have to pay the Zuli every time you're trying to upgrade it, so it can be a bit expensive if it keeps failing. But there we go. There we go for the shoes. And that one went without any failure. Now we have to buy some more bind runes. Let's try 4. Since defenders are pretty much next to each other, you can just buy small quantities, and if you need more, it's just a short walk. One more. Alright. Okay, so yeah, each of these are now grade 4, which means that the defense, magic defense, and dodge rate stats are increased. And so if we equip it, then we have higher overall defenses. And that can make a significant difference. I think I want to deal some more damage as well. So let's upgrade our pea shooter again. So yeah, first unequip it. We need second grade talismans. So let's buy a couple of those. Oh, the talismans are being sold by the weapons seller. There we go. These are a bit more expensive, as you can see, but we can afford them. Let's try 10. And then upgrade our weapon. Always leave some money for buying things like bullets. Well, these are free, but the higher level bullets may cost money, and especially if you're in need of food, you should always carry some money with you. So don't spend it all on upgrades. Yeah, let's just try to upgrade it as far as we can get with these 6 second grade talismans. Yeah, let's try once more. Alright. I guess that works. Yeah, we want to keep some money in our pockets. But 7 is really good, so that'll work out. We also need some more bullets, because we're running out. And I think I'll refill our food quantity. So yeah, bullets and other ammunition is sold by Spiro here in Zant. And we'll just you can carry multiple stacks with you if you need more bullets, but we'll be fine like this. Another thing, we used to have the Kropi as a form of transportation, but the Kropi is only available for 7 days, which is real time days, so even if you're offline, it'll still count down. And since it's been a couple of days since we played on this character, we've lost the Kropi, so we have to walk, but that's alright. Once you're level 50, you're gonna get the chicken, which is another mount, and that that one lasts for 30 days. Yeah, so let's buy some more food. $37. The food is really cheap, so you don't need too much cash, but I'd like to keep some of it around. And we also have some of the essences that we can sell, especially these elixirs. And let's see which ones buy for the most. So this one is not buying anything. Okay, 35 and 40 for these. Okay. Oh, now we're attacking the bee. So yeah, as you can see, the prices can be different among different players. So it's good to check all of them. Cause especially if they're so close together, they're usually competing for prices. 25. That's very low. So the actual price of these essences tends to be around 60k. That's what most people in the main city buy them for. So 35. I think 40 was the best we've seen so far. And yeah, so these players pretend to be really nice, trying to buy your items for you, but they tend to give you a lower price for these items than what you would get in the main capital, which is Tunipolis. But I guess 40,000 is good enough for us. So yeah, just drag them to the window. If you're making a dealer that's gonna craft gems later on as an artisan, you might want to hold on to these chemicals instead. Or just sell a few. Do we have anything else he wants? Dirty ores. So yeah, actually we can open our special package. We've been able to on level 18, so let's do that. And the next one is for level 25. So these just contain more boosters, just hold on to them for now. And yeah, let's continue doing these quests. We should be just a little bit stronger now, especially since we leveled up. Let's upgrade our concentration stats some more. There we go. And we have some skills left to skill points left to spend. I think we want to do something for now that helps us in battle. So let's try the gun training, which gives us 5% extra attack power plus another 5 points. So I like that. And the next level up we get to level 23, we'll get another skill point, which allows us to get the other skill, trigger finger. These ones you want to upgrade as soon as you can, because they help in battle. Alright, yeah. As you can see, they go down more quickly. They didn't even get an opportunity to attack, which is good. Sometimes they stand still. They do that because they're buffing themselves. And I like that because I can still fire my bullets at them while they're doing so. So we're at 15 now, but we want to make sure that we're also attacking the chefs. Because we need the chef sets as well, and the whoopee knives. Whoopee gluttons. So the grey ones are the gluttons. Be careful not to attack the king, because he will kill you. I'm just moving out of range of the other whoopies here, otherwise they might gang up on me. So as you can see, this is a shield type, so it takes much longer to kill it. And you need to be careful about your own health as well. But fortunately, we only need 3 knives, so we don't have to fight many of these, I hope. Sit down and eat some grapes. All right. I'm just gonna go for the chefs and the gluttons for now. So yeah, just pull them to a safe area, and then just kill them. So yeah, this might happen. You're fighting these monsters. Whoa, I got taken to the bridge here. Sometimes they just, it's like they call upon the help of other monsters, like reinforcements. But normally these monsters aren't aggressive. But that's just something you should be aware of. But we should be alright. And that's 2 knives. Let's find one more glutton. to heal up first. I think this should be a safe area. Paying attention. So yeah, the gluttons can be a bit tough. And if you're low level at this point, you don't have so much HP to carefully choose your tactics, because you're dead before you know it. But dying isn't a big deal, so... And the monsters will keep their low health. So you just come back and kill them. Getting close. Oh, we won. Haha. So we have the three knives now, so we just have to concentrate on the chefs. We should be able to out-heal his damage. And then we can pick up these, which gives us a nice healing boost. And once we have all the chefs set, we can just kill little Woopies until we have the requirement fulfilled. One more. And that's it. Let's pick up the items. Now there's also the stolen formula quest. As you can see, we already had one page, but we need the other page. But we can just kill Woopies for them. Or Woopie Chiefs. Let's try normal Woopies. This one deals quite a lot of damage here. Let's try the chests. So yeah, you can be very lucky with finding these pages, or it might take a long time. So just focus on killing lots of these. Need four more whoopies, and hopefully these will give us these little whoopies will also give us these formula pages. But just to be sure, we might kill a couple of chefs. As you can see, we're leveling up pretty fast still. So, if you feel that you're too weak to take on these quests within a reasonable time frame, then just train at some of the weaker monsters, maybe even in the previous area, until you're strong enough to fight them. Yeah, these whoopies can be quite powerful. They're not range units, but once they get to you, they can hit for quite a lot. One more whoopie. I think we really have to kill the whoopies and the chefs, not the little whoopies, but I might be wrong. Let's just heal up. I think the whoopee chefs are the best option. Maybe these assistants will drop the formula as well. Oh, we can't hold any more items. But that item isn't too valuable, so... Still no page. But still, it's good training, so... we'll get stronger. We should be level 23 once we kill this one. There we go. So yeah, let's add these skill points, stat points to our concentration stat. And we will learn the trigger finger skill, which gives us 10% attack speed. That's useful. That's another high ether. High ether. We'll have to drop something to be able to... oh, this is a quest item. I think it's related to an event. Let's drop this wood, because this is more valuable. Still no page. This can take a long time if you're unlucky. We got the first one pretty quickly, but usually it's the second one that takes a long time to get. But in the meantime, we're picking up some useful items as well. So yeah, I can tell you a bit about this bridge. This used to be the bridge towards Alvaloon Desert, but they've changed it so that there's only one way to get there via breezy hills. And they did that because people were creating new characters, and they would just quickly go to Junonpolis as a level 1 character, and they would also take this bridge to get there quickly, and then they would just use those characters for Zuli selling, which is trading Zuli for real life currencies. And one of the updates that was meant to stop those Zuli sellers getting to Junonpolis was removing or breaking this bridge, so you can't go over it anymore. And now everyone has to go through breezy hills, which means that it's another challenge to get to Junonpolis if you're level 1. At least that's what I've heard, so it might not be entirely correct. Now, killing these monsters might be a little boring, especially for Let's Play, but I'm trying to see how long it takes to level up and get through this game at a reasonable pace for a new player. So it's important that I don't cut out or skip anything. But yeah, it does mean that there's probably gonna be a lot of episodes throughout this game. Wow. That one hit like a truck. Still no page. We're getting close to an hour already, so I'm hoping that I can finish these quests before this episode ends. Yeah, the drop chance for these pages is really low. Come on, give me the page. Oh, there we go. We got the vaccine formula A page. So let's return to both Sparrow and Cornell. The good thing is that generally if you have to spend a lot of time or effort to do a quest, then its rewards are usually pretty good. So we'll probably get a lot of experience from this. I brought the vaccine formula. What? You actually did it? Well, yeah. Wahaha, I'm impressed. Thank you very much. Now I can finally get back to work on this vaccine. That's great. Good luck with your vaccine. But you know what? I can't make this vaccine with just a formula. Eh? What do you mean? Why don't you help me finish this vaccine project? After all, you do want to see this to the end, don't you? Oh no, it looks like I'm stuck. Right, I've got the perfect job for you. You see, I don't get along very well with the Orumix, so why don't you get their report of darkness from them for me?
Report of darkness?
Yes. Find Tritid Armor, the Orumix researcher, and she should give it to you, hopefully. Alright. Okay, so let's do that. So we got close to 5,000 experience from that. Not enough to level up, but I think the next quest will. I know much about the mysterious power of magic. Would you like to know anything? I hear that you have some report of darkness. Is there any way I can get a copy? Wait, who told you about the report of darkness? Oh, just a friend of mine. I don't think you know him. Oh, alright. As long as you didn't say Spiro. He and I don't actually get along. Ahem. Anyway, I wanted it to learn more about the Devil Pest for myself.
Really?
Okay. But I'll need a certificate from Cornell, the chief of Zant. He'll give it to you if you ask him.
Cornell's certificate?
Alright, I'll remember that. So that's really good, because we need to go to Cornell as well to turn in these quests. So that's good.
I have completed my task.
Excellent. Once you have completed both tasks for me, I may have some extra work for you. I've defeated some of the local Woopies. And there we go. We got 15,000 experience from that, so that's very good. And we turn in the other one. I have gathered up your cooking supplies. And there we go. That's level 25. How do I get a certificate from you? Why would you need one? Trita told me that I'd need your certificate if I want her to give me the report of darkness. Ah, you want to have an Arumic document. Well, I suppose you have to understand the Arumics. Ah, I see. Anyway, it's not like I don't trust you, but I can't easily give away this certificate. Alright, so what should I do? It will be enough if you deliver this letter to Lutis, another Arumic researcher, in Luxem Tower for me. Once you do that, I'll give you a certificate. So I should deliver this to Lutis. Got it. Okay, so that's the next step in this quest. And we'll talk to him again to get that extra work. What was that about extra work? Yes, of course. You've been most helpful in corralling these wicked little beasts.
Livestock farmer Lampard can be found just outside of town. He's having a bit of whoopee trouble. I think you ought to pay him a visit.
Certainly. I'll head right over there.
Right. So, this leads you to the farm and the guy there, Lampa. He gives you a quest to kill the Whoopee Prince. We'll do that next time, probably. For now, we can go to Luxem Tower quickly. Actually, it's been an hour already, I think, so I'm just gonna move here, and we're gonna close this episode for now, put an end to it. So yeah, next time we'll probably sell some of the items here, and we might actually upgrade our armor again. But yeah, that's it for this episode. It was a bit boring, but yeah, it's important to get an idea of how long it takes to progress through this game. And, you know, if you spend a lot of time and effort doing quests, then it should feel like a rewarding experience. And yeah. In the next episode, we'll probably finish these quests and kill the Whoopee Prince, and probably we'll go into the next area, which is Breezy Hills. Like this video if you like it, dislike it if you dislike it, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye.